Hello everyone, I'm Jean from Magento. In this video, I will show you how to create custom fields in the checkout page using Magento tool order attribute extension. This guide will walk you through four sections. First, we go into config the modules. Second, we create a new order attribute with our extension. And lastly, we're gonna show you where the attribute is available and see how its label looks in a certain store view. Okay, let's go. From the admin sidebar, go to sales. Here is our extension with three tabs, and we focus on all the attributes and settings. Let's start with settings. There are three sections: general settings, checkout page, and customer order details page. For the first section, here is the current version of the extension. In this field, choose yes to activate the extension. Display title is a title for the attribute block that appears on customer order details page, print out, and backend pages. We continue with some settings on the checkout page. In the show attribute field, you can decide whether to show the attribute on the checkout page. For the second field, we select yes to show the icon before the attribute. And when doing this, the icon field will later appear so that you can take your favorite one. After finish, let's skip to the last section. If you want customer to see and manage their additional information about the order, select yes to show attributes on the customer order details page. To include order attributes in PDFs of order, invoice, shipment, and credit memo, set yes to this field. The field allows you to show the icon before the title. In the field, you can select the wanted icon for the title of the attribute block. To enable the icon before the attributes, set yes to this field. Next, choose the icon for the attributes. If you need to customize the appearance of the title, attributes value, use the line the custom CSS field. So now it's time to create custom attribute with Magento order attribute extension. Head back to the sales. Click order attributes. And here is an order attribute grid. Click this button to create a new order attribute. In the left panel, we can see properties, manage labels and tooltips, display settings and conditions. In the properties tab, there are two main sections, attribute properties and advanced attribute properties. In the first one, enter the default attribute label. When you choose yes for required values, customer cannot skip the attribute field, thereby you can collect the most important information and understand them better. Input type allows you to display the attribute in an appropriate way. For instance, if you want to provide customers with a birthday field, the input type here should be date. In this case, we take multiple select. And a new section manage option appears so that you can add option for the attribute. In case you are running several stores, you can enter the translated option in those store views. In its default column, choose the default option on the storefront. To remove option, click here. Let's move on the advanced attribute properties.
The attribute code is used internally. Like when you need to add attribute to the email, you have to ask for its help. Make sure not to use spaces or more than 60 characters. If you leave this field blank, it's based on the default value. The default tooltip allows you to add specific instructions so that customer can know how to fill in the field. Click Save and continue to edit. After being saved, the name of the page is named after the attribute label. Also, you can now delete the attribute by clicking on this button. Moreover, the input type is disabled so that you cannot change another. Remember, because we didn't enter anything in the attribute code, the code will be updated based on the attribute label. All right, let's continue with manage labels and tooltips. This session gives you the ability to manage labels and tooltips in different store views. In this case, we enter translated label in Japan store view. Okay, click Save and continue edit with display settings. Display settings allows you to display the order attribute in the front end, back end, PDFs, emails, and so on. For the front end settings, you are able to show the attribute on the checkout page, customer order, invoice, shipment, and credit memo view. With the backend settings, you can make the attribute visible on the backend pages, namely order view, invoice view, shipment, and credit memo view page. Also, you can manage the attribute display in the backend grids. Okay, let's look at the advanced setting. For the first field, choose the position on the checkout page where the attribute is available. This extension offers you various options as shipping address, shipping method, and payment method. For the second field, you can show or hide the attribute label on backend pages, customer order detail page, and print out. The next field, sort order, allows you to decide the weather of the attribute field on the checkout page. The smaller the number is, the higher the priority is. Therefore, attributes with higher priority will be displayed above. If several fields have the same sort order number, the position are determined by creation time. The more recently the attribute is created, the more prior the attribute is. If you leave this field blank, the sort order will be set to 0 after being saved. So on store view, select the store view where the attribute is available. If you want to make the attribute visible to a certain customer group, this field can help. Click Save and continue edit. Now let's move on to the last section, condition. With this feature, you can assign the order attribute to the cart that meets given conditions. Let's suppose you want to offer customer 50% discount for all summer product. If the cart has any summer item, the attribute field apply 50% discount will show up. There are four types of condition that you can set. Product attribute combination, product sub-selection, condition combinations, cart attribute. For your better understanding, I'll explain about this feature in another video. Click Save Attribute. You are now landing on the attribute grid. After being saved, the attribute show up here.
Now let's check where to find the attribute. First off, let's see on the checkout page. Oh, here it is. Add the shipping method step. Click Next, then place order.
Now we're gonna check the attribute in the backend.
Go to the backend demo. There are 8 backend locations where you can find the attribute.
Order grid first. Here's the attribute. Invoice grid. See here. Continue tracking the attribute in shipment grid. There it is. And credit memo grid. See? Alright, let's see the attribute on the order, invoice, shipment, and credit memo view page. Head back to the sales. Select orders. Let's find the recent order. Click view. Here's the order view page. Scroll down to additional information to find the attribute. To see the attribute on the invoice view page, we first need to issue the invoice. To this end, click invoice. You are now landing on the new invoice page. The attribute also appears on this page. Click Submit Invoice and this invoice view page. Scroll down. Look at this. Let's do the same check with the attribute on the shipment and credit memo view page. That's all the backend locations. You can find the attribute. Now we're gonna check the attribute on the front end, namely customer order view, invoice view, shipment view, credit memo view, and their PDFs. Choose customer order view. We are now looking for a newly created order. From the left panel, click My Orders. Here's that order. In the action column, click its view order. At the item order tab, scroll down to find the attribute. Look there. Back to the top and click print order to see the attribute in the order PDF. Do the same check with customer invoice view, shipment view, credit memo view, and their PDFs. Now we're going to show you how the attribute label and tooltip looks in Japan Store View. Here's the result. And that's it. Hope you understand how to create an order attribute in the checkout page using Magento 2 Order Attribute extension. If you have any questions, leave a comment right below. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to our channels for more videos.